Children, last class we had covered the different advantages of ploughing. So ploughing comes under the preparation of the soil. The first step you have to deal with when you are carrying out cultivation, and we learned what are the advantages of preparing the soil or ploughing the soil. Hope you are remembering what we discussed. So one by one, I want to hear those four points from you. So who will tell me the first point? Who will tell the first advantage of ploughing? You don't wait for me to call out your name, children. You can unmute and you can just answer. Yes, Benedict. Yes.
They loosen the soil, further loosen the soil and helps in the growth of earthworms and microbes.
Okay, it will promote the growth of earthworms and microbes. Very good. Another point.
Ma'am, the loosened soil helps in the growth of microbes and earthworms.
That is the same point he told, no? Tell me another point. Same point he told. Think.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Navaneet, wait. Yes, Navaneet.
Ma'am, allows the root to penetrate deep into the
soil. Very good. Allows the roots to penetrate deep into the soil and to breathe easily. Next point. Next.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Turning and loosening of the soil brings the nutrient-rich soil to the top.
Very
and the
good.
Plants it will can
bring
absorb it.
The nutrient-rich soil to the top so that the plants can use it. And last point. One of you. Who's saying?
Ma'am.
Anybody?
It helps in proper mixing the manure with the
very
soil.
Very good. So it helps in proper mixing of the manure with the soil. So you people are very good children. You have covered, you've learned everything what was covered last day. So let us move towards today's topic. So today we are going to learn the different devices or different implements used for ploughing. So we'll be learning about three devices which are used for ploughing or preparing the soil. The first one is a plough, second one a hoe, and the third one, cultivator. So you are going to learn about three devices or three agricultural implements used for ploughing or preparing the soil. So with the help of the PPT, we will learn more about it. So as I told you, we are going to learn about the different devices, different implements used for ploughing the field. Just 1 minute, children. No doubt, no? Somebody I heard, you wanted to ask something, I heard a voice. Okay. So we are going to learn about the different agricultural implements which are used for preparing the soil. So let us see which are those. Already I told you the names of these devices. The first one is a plough. And plough, you can see in the figure, the picture of a plough. A farmer and two bulls together, they are operating the device known as plough. So let us learn more about a plough. It is used for tilling the soil, adding fertilizers, removing the weeds and scraping the soil. So we were discussing about the different implements used for ploughing. But a plough can be used for other purposes too. Not only for tilling the soil, you can use it for adding fertilizers, to remove the weeds, scraping the soil. For all these purposes, you can use a plough. Adding fertilizers, you're familiar. Tilling the soil, you know. Removing the weeds. What are weeds? The unwanted plants growing in the field. So in the crop, the farmer will be growing a particular type of crop or a particular type of plant. The other crops, the unwanted plants, not other crops, the unwanted plants growing along with the crop. Those are known as weeds. So plow will help in removing the weeds and scraping the soil. Scraping the soil means it's a method by means of which the hard surface layer is removed and the soil is renewed. Clear? Once again, I will repeat. We are discussing about the first device used for plowing. The name of the device is plow. Plow can be used not only for tilling the soil, you can use it for adding fertilizers, removing the weeds, and even for scraping the soil. Now, plow, you can even make it using wood or iron. Nowadays, the wooden plow is getting replaced by iron plow, which means either wood or metals like iron can be used for plowing, and it is drawn by a pair of animals. You need a pair of animals for this device to work. You can use either bulls, horses, or camels. In our country or in our state, we prefer bulls because that is easily available. So depending upon the place where it is carried out and depending upon the animals available, you can use any of these animals for plowing. So plow can be made out of wood or iron, and we need a pair of bulls, horses, or camels to operate this device. Now, next we are going to learn about the different parts of a plow. You should know about the different parts of a plow. Let us see what are the different parts of a plow. A plow is having two main parts. One is a plough shaft, the other one is a plough share. So a plough is having two main parts, a plough shaft and a plough share. So let us see what are these parts. And a strong triangular iron strip which forms a part of the plough is known as plough share. I'll repeat again. A strong triangular iron strip present as a part of the plough is known as ploughshare, and a piece of wood, a log of wood, which forms a part of the plough is known as plough shaft. A plough is having two parts. These are ploughshare and plough shaft. And once again, I will repeat, a plough is a device used for ploughing, adding fertilizers, scraping soil, removing weeds, etc. And it is having two main parts. It's having two main parts, a ploughshare and a plough shaft. What is a ploughshare? The strong triangular iron strip is known as ploughshare, and it is also having a long log of wood that is known as plough shaft. Together they make a plough. And you can see again the picture of a plough, a farmer and the bulls together operating a plough. And there is a handle. You can see a handle at one end of the plough shaft. Once again, at one end of the plough shaft, you can see, what can you see? At one end, you can see a handle. So you can see a handle at one end of the plough shaft. And the other end is attached to a beam which is placed on the neck of animal. See here. So the other end is attached to a beam. This is the beam, and this end is attached to the beam, which is kept at the back of the bulls. Once again, we were discussing about the different parts of a plough. A plough is having two main parts, plough share and a plough shaft. This one is a plough share, and this is known as plough shaft. Plough shaft is a long log of wood, whereas ploughshare is a strong triangular iron strip. And you can see a handle at one end of the plough shaft, and the other end is attached to a beam which is placed on the neck of animals. Hope you have no doubts. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
You want me to repeat? Anybody wants me to repeat? No. Okay. Then I will move on to the next one. Ho. So before I proceed to ho, do you want to see it once again? Anybody? Lakshmi Nandakumar, you want to say something?
No, ma'am.
No. You have understood. No need to repeat. No need to repeat. Yes or no, children?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Going to learn about the next device, that is ho. Ho is also used for preparing the soil. And it can be used not only for loosening or preparing the soil, you can even use it for removing weeds, removing the unwanted plants. Ho is a second device. We use it for removing the weeds as well as for loosening the soil. Now, you can see the picture of a ho here. Okay, now let's see what are the different parts. It has got two main parts. Here also, just like we said in the previous case, here also two main parts are there. And here there is a long road. You can see a long road here. And at the same time, there is a broad, strong, bent iron plate. So this is the first part and this is the second part. Once again, I will repeat, a ho consists of a long rod of wood, and this can be, this rod can be either made of wood or iron. And to that, you can see a bent plate where I have marked two. A strong, broad, bent iron plate is attached with very sharp ends, and it works like a blade. You can see that bent iron plate is having a very sharp edge, and this works like a blade when it is moved through the soil. I'll repeat once again. Ho is a simple tool, and for working a ho also, we need animals. We need a pair of animals to work this device too, just like a plow. And for what we use it? For removing the weeds and for loosening the soil. And coming to the parts, it consists of a long rod of wood. It can be even made out of iron. And attached to this long rod of wood or iron, you can find a strong, broad, bent iron plate, which is very sharp, and it works like a blade as it passes through the soil and helps in removing the weeds and loosening the soil. Hope you have no doubts. Any doubts, you can stop me in between. Now moving on to the third device. Cultivator. So we learned about a plough. After that, we discussed about hoe, and the third one is a cultivator. Cultivator is worked, or we operate a cultivator using a tractor. I hope you are familiar with a tractor. Tractor is a device or a vehicle we use in the farmlands. Cultivator is attached to a tractor. You can see the picture of a tractor to which a cultivator is attached. This one is the cultivator, and that is attached to a tractor. So this is tractor. It's a machine, or you can call it as a vehicle used in farmlands. And you can find here a cultivator attached to the tractor. Okay, now plowing is done using a tractor-driven cultivator. So cultivator is attached to a tractor, and that is used for plowing nowadays, because farmers too prefer this device. The reason is, since it is machine or mechanized, it will save the time and labor. The farmer need to take only less effort and it saves the time. Here no bulls or no animals are used. Here we need a man to operate the tractor. That's enough. And it saves the effort and time of the farmers. So with that, we have completed the three devices used for ploughing. So quickly, I will just have a recapitulation of all the points we said now. And after that, you should answer my questions. Okay, children? Now, we'll start from where we began. We started with a plough, and I told you that a plough is a device used for tilling the soil, adding fertilizers, removing the weeds, and scraping the soil. A plough can be made of wood or iron, and we need a pair of animals. It can be bulls, horses, or camels. And it has got two main parts, a plough share and a plough shaft. Plough share is a strong triangular iron strip, whereas plough shaft is a long log of wood. Okay, very important, plough share and plough shaft. And you can see the picture of the plough here. And the next point, there is a handle at one end of the plough shaft, and the other end of the plough shaft is attached to a beam which is placed on the neck of the bulls. After that, we moved on to the next device, that is a hoe. Hoe is a simple device. Here also we need animals to operate this, and it is used for removing the weeds and for loosening the soil. Now, coming to the parts of a hoe, it has got a long rod of wood or iron, and to that you can see a strong, broad, bent iron plate is attached, which works like a blade. And once it is moved through the soil, it will help in removing the weeds and loosening the soil. And finally, we discussed about a cultivator. In cultivator, farmers prefer a cultivator for ploughing the field, because here we make use of a tractor. Tractor is a vehicle or a device used in farmlands, and cultivator is attached to it. It is much more easy. It will save the time and labor of the farmers. Any doubt? Any doubt?
Okay. No.
So with that, we have completed the different devices used for ploughing. Which are the different devices used for ploughing? Pooja, which are the different devices used for preparing the soil?
Ma'am, a plough, yes, or a hoe, or a cultivator.
Okay, tractor-driven cultivator. So these are the three devices used for ploughing. For what purposes, for what all purposes you can use a plough? Only for tilling? Only for tilling the soil? Irene?
No.
Irene, tell me for which all purposes we are using a plough?
Removing weeds.
Removing weeds? Only for removing
scraping
weeds?
The soil. Scraping the soil.
Scraping the soil. Then? Preparing the soil, definitely. Tilling the soil, removing the weeds,
and adding fertilizers.
Adding fertilizers. Very good. Which are the two main parts of a plough? Ritvik, two main parts of a plough.
Plough shaft and plough share.
Plough shaft and plough share. What are these plough shaft and plough share? Nandana, what are or what do you mean by a plough shaft and a plough share?
Ma'am, a plough shaft is a strong triangular iron.
Plough shaft.
Sorry, a plough share.
Long.
A plough share is a long. Plough
shaft is a
long log of wood.
Okay. Okay. Then what is plough share, Sridev? What is plough share?
Long log of wood. Is plough.
She told about plough shaft, that is a long log of wood. Shaft, log of wood.
Triangular iron strip.
Triangular iron strip. Don't get confused between both. Shaft, it's a log of wood. Okay? And plough share is the triangular iron strip. Don't get confused between both. Surya, can you repeat plough share, shaft and plough share? Surya?
Ma'am, can I say?
Lynette is saying, where is Surya? Okay, Lynette, tell me the answer.
Plough share. It is an triangular iron strip. Plough shaft. It is a long log of wood.
Very good, very good. And now what about hoe? Nivedya, can you tell me what you know about a hoe?
Ma'am, it is a simple tool used by animals for turning and loosening the soil.
Okay. Another point, wait. Advait, tell me another point. Another point about hoe. Nivedya told one point. Advait, can you tell me the next point?
Used for removing weeds.
That she told. Tell me something about its structure. What are the different parts?
It consists of a long rod.
Very good.
Of wood or iron. With a strong, broad and bent iron plates.
Very good. Okay. Now, which is the device presently used or most commonly used device for ploughing nowadays? Vaishnavi, which device is preferred by the farmers? And you should tell me why it is being preferred. Vaishnavi, answer.
Ma'am?
You heard my question? Which device is preferred by the farmers for ploughing?
Nowadays, they use cultivators.
Why we prefer that?
Because it saves labor and time.
Very good. Because since it is working with the help of a tractor, it will save time and labor. Okay? So now, what is the next step, next agricultural practice, children?
Sowing.
So today we have 5 more minutes. We'll just begin the introduction of the next agricultural practice I'll give you, and after that we'll continue in the next class. So up to here we had completed. Next we are going to learn about sowing. So sowing is the most important part of crop production. The most important, if it is asked, which is the most important step in crop production, you should write, it is sowing. Okay? And in sowing, the farmers should select good seeds. He should select good quality seeds, which are clean, healthy, and of good variety. Otherwise, what will happen is, if the seeds the farmers are selecting, they are not of good quality, however he tries, or whatever steps or whatever measures he takes, how much ever effort he puts, he will get a very poor yield. So a major part of the crop production depends upon the seeds which he is selecting. Okay, so he should select good quality seeds. They should be clean, healthy, and of good variety. Only then he can get a better yield. Okay, children? Sowing is the most important part of crop production. You have to select good quality seeds which are clean, healthy, and of good variety. When I say good variety, you can some features of the seeds can be high yielding, disease resistance, etc. So the farmers should always go for the best quality seeds if he needs a very good yield at the end. Clear, children? So more about sowing you will be learning in next class. So which is the most important step in crop production? Tamanna?
Sowing.
The most important step in crop production?
Sowing.
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 Okay, very good. So what type of seeds he should select for sowing, Isha? What type of seeds should be selected for sowing?
Good quality seeds which are clean, healthy and of good variety.
Okay, good. Okay, so we'll wind up our session for today. Learn today's portions. Any doubt before I wind up? Do you have any doubts?
No
doubts. Okay. So shall we wind up?
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.